Hi DIYers, Sterling with AlarmGrid here. Today we're going to show you how to program a 5815 wireless door and window contact. This sensor is very similar to the popular 5816 contact that's often sold in the kit with the LynxTouch L5200 system. Unlike the 5816, it's got a slightly better look, whereas the 5816 is bigger and boxier. This one has a nice thin profile with rounded edges and gives you a better decor for your home. It is a surface mount contact, unlike a recessed. You will see this on your door or your window, but with the nicer body style, some people prefer this device over the 5816. It comes with two pieces, the magnet and the contact, along with some mounting screws and some double-sided tape as well. At the bottom of the box, you also have your battery, which powers the unit. It's a 3-volt lithium battery that you use to give power to the unit. So once you unbox everything, you have your CR123A, your lithium battery. You have your magnet, which is a 5899B. Just like with the 5816, has a bigger, boxier magnet. The 5815, which has the nicer look, it has the nicer look on the magnet as well, so you get the nice rounded beveled edges on both. You get a spacer in case you need to bring your magnet up off the wall a little bit to get it in line with the sensor, and you get your mounting materials. So, this device is used to protect openings, doors and windows from opening, for intrusion detection. And on the side here, this little piece of plastic here lines up between, it's going to be hard to see in the video, but there are faint hash marks at the base of this unit. There are no hash marks on this side, and also this little plastic flange on the back is lined up with those. The reason they put that is to show you that the magnet should be installed on this particular side of the sensor. Mounting the magnet on this side will not work. Internally inside this device is a mercury reed switch, and it happens to be on this side of the sensor. So mounting it this way, or this way will not work. Mounting it this way is where you'll get your proper fault and restoral of the zone when the door is opened or closed. So to program it, we have to give it power first. There is a small indent here for a flathead screwdriver, only on one of the short edges. And if we put our screwdriver in there and pry it open, we can pop the cover off of the device. And you can see internally, we have a few things going on here. We have our antenna, which is this wire that goes around. We have our push button tamper switch so that we know if the cover's popped or not. We have our battery position, and it says observe polarity with a minus and a positive. So we can slide our battery in, negative to negative, positive to positive. That gives us our power. And then this little red device at the bottom is our reed switch, and that indicates the proper magnet alignment. And one more thing to point, this one is unique. It actually does in fact have a reed switch on this side. So while I said you should have it mounted in line with these two hash marks, technically this would work this way as well. Unlike the 5811 sensor, which only operates as a wireless transmitter with its magnet, this 5815, just like this 5816, does have a set of internal screw terminals. If you wire a wired contact into these terminals, this device could simply sit on the wall and act as a transmitter, a wireless transmitter, that would accept the input from an alarm on a door protected by a wired input or a wired contact. So you would simply land your two wires to here, and then this is acting as a wireless transmitter back to your LynxTouch unit. When you're programming it, if you're going to use the two internal screw terminals, you use loop number one, and if you're going to use your reed switch and your magnet, you're going to use loop number two. So we're going to show you that with the programming. So we're ready to program now that we know how the 5815 sensor works. So to get into programming, from the home screen, it's Security, More, Tools. After tools, you need to type in your installer code, which is 4112 by default. And now we can select program to get into system programming. From there, we go to zones. And if we hit the down arrow until we get the next available new zone, we always want to ignore zone one because that's only a wired input. So you can't program a wireless device to zone one. If you go to edit screen on zone one, you'll notice the serial number and the loop number are not even available. They're just blanked out. But if we go down and select zone 19 and do edit, now we have the option to click into serial number and key in the serial number. On this device, we have our alpha number followed by our 7-digit serial number. We also have that sticker on the outside of the device in case the cover's on, we know how to program it. Instead of keying in the serial number, which would leave us open to user error on the inputting of the number, what we can do is activate the device three times. So to activate a door contact, what you do is you put the magnet next to the reed switch. We're in line with the plastic indication of where the reed switch is on the backside, and we pull apart to show the door opening. The single activation caused a beep at the panel. Putting it close together again and pulling it away gives us the serial number and the loop. Because it can tell we're activating the internal reed switch, it learns in with loop number two. If we had our contact wired to these internal screwed contacts and we were activating the external wired contact, it would have automatically known to learn in loop number one. So this auto enrollment is a very nice way to program your sensor because then you can't have issues with loops. That would cause faults when the door is open and things like that, which can throw people off. So if you do the auto enrollment, it ensures that you're putting it into the system properly. Finally, we need one third and final activation. So we put the magnet close and pull it away a third time, and now we have our proper serial number and loop number, and we're ready to program the rest of the parameters for our zone 19 5815 sensor. First thing we want to select is the device type. In here, we have a lot of options, but when doing a 5815, 99% of the time, you're going to choose door or window. In this case, we're going to put this in our dining room, and we want to choose that it's going to be on a window. So we do device type window, which auto selects the response type of perimeter. If we highlight the response type box, you can select and choose various options that would possibly work with a window. More often than not, you're going to use perimeter because if the window is open when the system is armed, you would want that to sound the alarm right away. You don't need a delay coming in through a window because you're not going to be entering your home through a window. So again, if the system is armed and the window opens, most often you want that to sound the alarm right away. And by selecting perimeter for the response type, that's the functionality you're going to get. The last thing we want to do is name the type of window it is. Again, if we had left it simply window, we would have to remember that zone 19 is our dining room window, and it would only say window when active. If we go ahead and select D for dining room, it takes us to the first D word in the available library.
Delay door.
We can hit the down arrow until we get to dining room, or we can use a shortcut.
Dining.
Hitting the I will take us to the first DI word, which happens to be dining. Now that's a good word, but we go one more.
Dining room.
And we get a nice clean word of dining room window. So now if the zone is active, we will hear dining room window alarm. If we had two windows in the dining room, we could further clarify.
Laundry left.
And we could call it dining room left window. So these zone descriptors, along with the device type, allows you to name the zone so that anyone in the house that's hearing the panel would know exactly what's going on. The next question is alarm report. Yes means send the alarm when activated to the central station. No means sound the alarm locally at the panel, but don't send to the central station. More often than not, if your system is monitored, you want that to be set to yes. Chime. You can hear when I selected the standard chime away from the default, we heard the beep, 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 and that is what you would hear when the door is, or the window is opened and the system is disarmed. Of course, in the alarm mode, if it's armed and it opens, you'd hear the full siren, but the chime is a way to get a beep, beep, beep at the system when the window is opened in the disarmed state. And then the final question is supervision. As discussed in every sensor programming video, supervision means that the system will check for the device programmed with this serial number every 12 hours. If this device was damaged or if it's too far away from the panel, or if there was interference in the house causing the transmitter not to talk back to the panel, you would get a supervision trouble on zone 19, and you would be alerted in advance that you have an issue with this sensor, and don't expect this sensor to actually activate if opened in the arm state. So we always want to do supervise so that we know in advance of any issues. If we save it, we can see dining room left window is locked in. And before we exit all the way to the home screen, if we put the cover back on, there's three little hinges and three little tabs that you simply line up at the bottom and then snap shut at the top. Now we're closed up. We're not going to have a tamper problem. If we put our magnet close to the sensor, typically the magnet goes on the moving portion of the door or the window, and then the sensor goes on the frame. So if we had a window that slid up, we would put this on the window edge, and we put this on the frame edge. And when the window opens, it faults, and when the window comes back down in line, then it's ready to go. If we exit to the home screen, we can show and prove that our programming is good. So right now we have our window closed, and we're going to open our dining room left window by sliding it up.
Dining room left window.
You can see the panel goes from green, ready to arm, to yellow, not ready to arm, fault, and you get a nice visual indication of what's open, and it tells you specifically the zone number and the name of whatever you name that window. So if you go to arm the system to leave the house and you're getting an indication that there's a fault, the panel will tell you exactly what zone is in trouble. And once you close the window, slide it back down and bring the magnet in place, you'll notice we didn't have to key in any disarm commands or acknowledge anything here. The fault simply cleared on its own, and now the zone is happy. So our 5815 Honeywell wireless sensor is now properly programmed to our LynxTouch L5200 system. We hope this video has been informative. We invite you to subscribe to our channel, and if you have any questions on your 5815 wireless sensor, we invite you to email us support@alarmgrid.com.